Hello everyone and welcome to a new video. First, I just want to apologize for not posting last week. I was dealing with some personal matters and couldn't find the time to edit and post a new video. But I'm really excited for today's video because it's a little spring manga haul. So starting with the single volumes, I picked up the final volume of Dreaming Sun. I don't know why it took me so long to get it considering it was one of the only series that I was consistent with. But nonetheless, I finally got it, and I will probably have to reread the entire series again since I pretty much forgot most of it. I also picked up volume 4 of Hatsuharu, which I really enjoyed because it's from the perspective of the male lead, which I feel like isn't something very common in shoujo mangas, or at least in the ones that I've read. I don't know if that changes, but from what I remember in the first three volumes, that's the case, so hopefully it stays like that, and I can't wait to continue reading the series. And the last single volume that I got is Fruits Basket Another, and spoiler alert for those of you that are watching the anime and have not read the manga, this is your spoiler alert to move forward a few minutes. But yeah, this is the final volume of Fruits Basket Another, and I think it's a really great way to wrap up the Fruits Basket series as a whole. We get to see the children of the Somas, and we get to know who the pairings are, and I just think it's super cute, and this is definitely a must read for anyone who is a fan of Fruits Basket. Up next, I got the first two volumes of A Sign of Affection. And I really like how this series takes place in college rather than high school. I just feel like it adds a bit more maturity to this series. Our main girl is also deaf, which I really like seeing because I love to see representation in media, and especially in manga, where I feel like it's not very common, especially in a shoujo manga. So yeah, I'm currently caught up with this series and I'm really excited to continue reading more. Next up, I have volumes 5 and 6 of Wake Up Sleeping Beauty, which are the final two volumes, and I'm really excited to finish this story. I really enjoyed the supernatural aspect and I just can't wait to see how the story wraps up. And I really like that these two volumes are like super thick, so I'll definitely be spending a lot of time just reading them and finishing up a really great story. Next, I got The Demon Prince of Momochi House volumes 7, 8, and 9. So yeah, this is another supernatural series, but if you're like into demons and stuff like that, then you're gonna like this one because it's really good. The plot is really good. The art style is really nice. And I have just been really enjoying the story overall, and yeah, it's a really good one. So next, I picked up the final three volumes of Waiting for Spring. I kind of remember this series a little bit. I might need to refreshen up my mind by reading the last volume that I own, but I mean, I think it's kind of obvious how it's going to end in this next few volumes. I think it's been pretty obvious from the beginning who our main girl is going to end up with. But yeah, I just can't wait to just finish it and read it and see how the series wraps up. But yeah. And the final series that I got is from Right Stuff, which is my personal favorite place to buy manga because it is so affordable. But I picked up Kiss Me at the Stroke of Midnight volumes 8 to 11. And I'm pretty sure there's one more volume that needs to be released, but it got pushed into next year, so it's gonna be a while before we see the end of the series. But I remember it stopping on a cliffhanger, so I'm pretty familiar, I think, with the story. I just might need to read the last volume just to freshen up my memory. But yeah, other than that, I really enjoy this art style, and I hope we get more physical volumes of this author's work because I'm pretty sure they're coming out with a new series. And there's one more other series that they've made that I read a really long time ago online that I really, really like. And I know that it's a digital release, but I'm not a fan of digital. So I'm hoping we get a physical release of that series. But yeah, so that is my manga haul. That is basically just shoujo, which is my favorite genre of manga. But yeah, I have tons of manga that I need to read now, a lot of things that I need to reread. So maybe I'll post a manga reading vlog in the future. But thank you all so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And I will see you all next week, hopefully. I think I'm going to post a vlog next week, I believe, if everything goes to plan. So thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye!